Welcome back to my Let's Play of Khan Academy, World of Math. We're now at 372 skills mastered. Only another 1,000 to go or so. Let's keep going. Evaluate the following expression. Yum yum. Let's see, let's switch over to our trusty Wacom. Here we go. So, can ignore the one. Let's see. That's a positive 30. Let's see, 1632 times 9 over negative 3. So, this is 3, and this is just negative. So, you want to do 3 times that. So, that's 9, and then 6, negative 96, looks like. Negative 96. No. Why have you failed me? Is that because, it's not actually a multiplication right there, is it? Alright, so this is negative 4 minus 8 times minus 3. So that's positive, so negative 4 plus 8 times 3, which is 16 plus 8, which is, I always hate the 8 times 3 stuff, I think it's 24, yeah, 24, so that's 20. Median number of basketball players made by 7 players in a certain basketball game is 5. The range is 4. Which of the statements are true? Excuse me. If fewer than 4, if the fewest baskets is made is 4, the greatest number of baskets made is 9. So the mean is the center, the average number. And the range, I always forget what this range is.
Let's say that we run a car dealership. Let me write this.
So the mean is the minimum. And the range is the min minus the max. So we write that
down. Range is going to be our max minus our min. So let me write that down. So you take your min and your max, you have your range. The range is equal to the maximum minus the minimum. And they're telling us that that is 4. This range is 4. So the maximum minus the minimum.
And then
we will now begin our journey to that role of averages.
The mean is that one, and the median,
set of numbers,
median is
the
middle number. Okay, median is the middle number. I always forget the stat stuff, so rarely use it. So we have 7 players, certain basketball game, oops, so 5, and then the range of those guys is 4. Alright, so if the fewest is 4, the greatest is 9. I don't think so, because the range is 4. The area of the triangle. Huh. I don't recognize this one.
We know that we can find the area of a rectangle by multiplying the base times the height. The area of a rectangle is equal to base times height. In another video, we saw that If we're looking at the area of a parallelogram, and we also know the length of a base, and we know its height, then the area is still going to be base times height. Now, it's not as obvious when you look at the parallelogram, but in that video, we did a little manipulation of the area. We said, hey, let's take this little section right over here. So we took that little section right over there, and then we move it over to the right-hand side. And just like that, you see that as long as the base and the height is the same as this rectangle at or its base height. Well, to think about, I'm gonna rotate it around like that. Rotate it around like that. I have now area of our original triangle, parallelogram. Let's go ahead, parallelogram. Well, we already saw area of our original triangle. I have half. Okay, maybe it'll be well, this angle right over here is greater than 90 degrees, but I'm gonna do the same trick. We have the base, and then we have the height. Here, you can think of if you start at this point right over here, and if you drop a ball, the length that the ball goes, or if you had a string here to kind of get to the ground level, you could view this as the ground level right over there, that's going to be the height. It's not sitting in the triangle like we saw last time, but it's still the height of the triangle. If this was a building of some kind, you say, well, this is the height. How far off the ground is it? Well, what's the area of this going to be? Well, you can imagine it's going to be 1/2 base times height. How do we feel good about that? Well, let's do the same magic here. So let me copy and paste this. Copy and then paste it. Whoops, that didn't work. Copy goes now. Flip it over. Move it over here. I'm going to rotate it a little bit more. So I think you get the general idea. It has to be area, which is our half base times height, while the area of a rectangle or a parallelogram is going to be base times.
Okay, so it's 1/2 base times height, huh? So 20. No problem. Let's see. Balls made in each game of the billiard tournament. So how many more games had 12 to 15 balls made? Eight versus 1/7. Closest measure of the angle. 45. Express this in scientific notation. 9.647 times 10 to the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 10 to the 7th. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There we go. Mastery of 400 unique skills. Nice. Another badge. Complete the equations to solve. So if we want something by 300 divided by 6. Yeah, 6, 10, 310. Area of the triangle is 1/2 base times height, so 60. So 210. Which of the following shows a dashed green ray? I think it's this one.
What I want to do in this video is, does that have a on
line
and rays? And I think
yeah, that's a ray. Figure A. Which of the following accurate descriptions. The distribution has a gap from a cluster on 7, 8. I don't think so. Let me watch
this. In this video, I want to do some examples looking at distributions, in particular different features in distributions like clusters, gaps, and peaks. For the shelf of days, so there, distribution has an outlook. It's Princeton, Iowa, in July 20. This is a high. Which of the following are accurate for the other time? For each apple at Gord data points, is an out plot of the distribution below. Select all that apply. So the first statement is the district over here, we have a lot of data points between 0 and 6. And just let's think about what they're measuring. This is shelf time for each apple at Gorges Grocer. So, for example, we see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 apples. So 3, 4, 5 going to be good for these. And you have one apple outlier here. It has a way larger, I would say larger outlier. It's 6 days and you do, let me do a few more. In 4 and 6 days, and you definitely do see that cluster there. Let me do one data point here that's at the high end, and I have another data point here that's that had a.
Let's see, what is gap and cluster?
High temps. 8 days of guests. Either spelling our accurate descriptions of the on the 20.
Man, his audio is kind of shitty in this video.
Really high.
All right. Distribution has a gap. I don't see a gap. I don't see a cluster. How many houses are on Pine Street side of each house? Four. Like this. Oops. Put it back. Like that. 4 plus 7 plus 9 plus 4 plus 1. So that's 5. That's 14. That's 11. That's 25. Right. Badges earned Helen Keller. Earned 750,000 energy points. Helen Keller was blind and deaf. And with the help of a teacher, did a bunch of cool stuff. You should check out an autobiography about her. She's pretty neat. Which of the following is accurate descriptions of the distribution below? Has a gap between 8 and 7? Nope. Has a cluster between 2 and 5? Nope. How many more pickles than onions are on the jumbo hamburger? 11 minus, sorry, 12 minus 4 is 8 pickles. How do you evaluate this step by step? Divide everything by 3. Let's see. Doesn't look like there's a mistake to me. 3, 3, yep. 3, 10. That looks good. Which of the statements are about the two yellow stripes are correct? They're not parallel to each other. Perpendicular. What's 48 minus 28? 44 minus 28. Minus 28, 3, 1, what is that, 6, 16. That's a line. A All right. Mastering some more stuff. Evaluate the following expression. One. Which of the following is a line of symmetry?
For each of these diagrams, I want to think about whether this blue line represents an axis of symmetry. The cross and see if, so this point right over here, this distance to the blue line, let's go at the same amount on the other side, would get you right there. And so you put the poly, think about it there. Same thing like this, might be actually on the other side of this blue line. So in this case, the blue line is not picked up like a mirror, some type of a lake.
Okay. Which one is an axis of symmetry? Not B. It looks like A. Loves to hide bones. Find the median number of bones. Arithmetic mean is, just to check again,
measure that's when you add them plus up. 1 plus 6.
Yeah. Alright, so 4, 5, 10, 13. So we gotta do the middle of these guys, so that's 15 divided by 2. Looks like great. Which is 7.5, as far as I can tell, yeah, that's 14, 7.5. Use line segments to connect all possible pairs of A, B, C, and then complete the statement. These line segments, because they have two endpoints and they continue forever in zero direction, sounds like. Perpendicular. How? 5 of them landed. A group of witches flew around the city. 5 landed and 12 were left. How many flew around the city? 17. Nice. Which of the following is a line of symmetry? Choose all answers that apply. They all look pretty symmetrical to me. Is C symmetrical? Maybe C's not, because C's kind of like, I don't know. Yeah, I'm gonna say C isn't. Which of the angles marked with X? So I think that's 67.
What I want to do in this video is prove that. So let's say that we just have to CA, for example, we want to prove that CAB is positive for instance, right over angle. They are bonding. See what's the first part. It's ABCD, and AB is a transversal. Transversal AC is a transversal of who have to be congruent to each other. So we see that if we have opposite angles that are congruent, then, or if we have a parallelogram, then the opposite angles are going to be congruent.
Yeah, 67. Evaluate the following expression. Alright, so we have negative 8 minus or plus 10 plus or minus 7. So plus 3 minus 8, that's minus 5. 5, 6, 7, 8, yep. Sounds like minus 5 to me. Following table shows the number of animal crackers in each kid's lunchbox. Find the median number of animal crackers. So we have 2, 2, 3, 5, 7, 7. So it's not the average, it's like the center number. So we have two center numbers, so 4. Drag the line so they go through point A and D. And the other line goes through B and C. These are lines because each have no endpoints and continue forever in two directions. Combined like terms. So we have negative 6/5 plus 4/15. So multiply by 3, so that's 18. So minus 14/15. And the other one is negative 1/3 V. Negative 1/3 V, 14/15. Sounds good to me. What is the volume of this rectangular prism? So we gotta multiply all these together. Oops. 5/2 times 1/3 times 3/4. 4/10. It's 12, right? 4, 12, 9, 12. Divide by 3, 30. So 30 plus 4 plus 9, 12. So that's what, 13, 43. 12, something crazy like that. No.
Let's see if we can calculate. I encourage you to use it. Area of base is Q. So let's calculate to an improv, which is what's going to be. And the denominator, we can just multiply the denominators. So it's going to be 6.
Oh, not, I was adding, wasn't I?
Simplify, divide that, both divisible by.
Okay. I just screwed that up big time. was adding the fractions, not multiplying them. Three-fourths, one-third. So 15. 12 times 2 is 24. 15 20-fourths. Reduced to simplest form. Let's see, 1/3 plus 3/5. So here's where we add. So we multiply that by 5 and make that a 5. And make that a 15. And make multiply this by 3, so that's 9. So minus 5 plus 9, 15. Which is plus 4. 4/15. Rectangle ABCD is graphed in the coordinate plane. The following vertices are blah. Given these coordinates, what is the length of AB, side of the rectangle? Let's see, so A is in 5, 1. And there's another dude at 7-1. That just looks like 2. Three, six, eight, nine. How many animals are relaxing by the pond? Looks like 4 to me. Tunnel of Fear climbs straight up 50 meters above the ground, then it drops 65 into an underground tunnel. What is the elevation of the tunnel relative to the ground? Negative 15. Reduced to simplest form. Negative 1/2 minus 3/5, so 10, 5, 10, multiplied by 2, 6, so minus 11, 11/10. Maximum distance for a regulation FIFA soccer field or 90 by 120. Draw a soccer field with maximum dimensions in the coordinate plane with the upper left corner at negative 50, comma 50. Okay, then it wants 60. So it wanted to be here. Okay, that looks like 60. No, that's 90. That's nice, it gives you a length. Does it tell you how long? Why does it tell you that length? It'd be nice if it told you that length too. Alright, that's 50. And this would be 100. This would be 120. So the longer side is parallel. What does it want this to be, 120? Is that what it wants? 50, and then it wants this to be 90. That's just 2/7. All right. No, 7/5. 7/2. 7/2. There we go. That's an easy one. Make one at -5, 0. And another one at -5, 9. And another one at 0, 9. Total profit from April to June. So -8. So +2 is -6. +4 is -2. So that's 180. 180 minus 34. 7, 10, 6. 4, 146, looks like. Sweet. And I think that's a good stopping point for the episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time.